Hello and welcome back. This is Rhino Knowledge number 20. If you don't know this series, please check out the link here for more information. And we will continue with the Rhino surface tools. And we will jump right in. Last time we looked, we came to this symbol here, fillet surface. And when we opened this, we realized that there's actually a submenu which is called surface tools, which is the same as here in the toolbar, surface tools. So let's keep this open and we will first look into that, the control points. That's just one video about control points. We looked into that already in the curves, but yeah, it looks a bit boring here, but it's not. Believe me, it's not. Yeah, the point edit. So this is pretty interesting. So we did the same here with the curves. So when we were drawing curves, we were able to use these tools, but they not just work for curves, they also work for surfaces. So we were able to, let's say, show the control points, show the edit points, curve edit points, hide the edit points, add, insert control points, insert knots, remove knots, kinks, and so on. And we can do the same with surfaces. So if we, for example, have a surface like this, then now I can show my, by the way, this only works with surfaces, single surfaces. It also, to some degree, it works with solids. Yeah, I can show my control points and I can select the control points and move these. Now I can add, so if I try to show this one, that doesn't work with surfaces, it only works with curves. Show the curves, select curves and sub D's for edit point display. That only works for sub D's, which are also type of surfaces, which we look into another time. Then hiding the points, that was the same as before. This also is here with the right click. You can hide, you can turn the points off and on. Then you can insert control points. And remember that control points are different to curve edit points or interpolated points, right? So there you might remember that we had the curve and then these are control points on your curve, these ones, and these are interpolated points on the curve. These are different things. Anyway, on the surface, it works a bit like the knots. So, but to make things more clear, okay, I can try to add control points. That allows me to add control points along the surface in one direction. Or if I go here, direction, I can change the direction this to this direction. With the toggle, I can also change it. It means if I press T, then I can also change that. That's pretty cool. So let's just add this here and we add one here. Now, if we now turn on the control points again, then we have these new control points. I will add another one here in the middle, so we get a bit more, we can adjust a bit more. T, okay, so we have now these. And you can see what it does, so I can move my points around. And it depends a bit on what type of surface it is. If it's just a flat piece, if I started with a flat piece, then these edges are all very sharp. However, if I do this, if I have a surface like this, then the result is a different one. So I can now add again, I can add, very interestingly, these here. Again, I try this again. Yeah, it's basically within, because my control points are here, so it creates control points. Yeah. If I now turn on my control points, you can see it's like this. So there's a difference. So here the control points are very strictly on the surface, whereas here they actually they actually describe, or these basically these work more like surface points, and these are control points which are defining the curvature of the object. So you can see if I move these, it's a different approach than this one. I'm wondering if I could. No, I cannot. But I hope, hope it makes sense. So now let's try removing these control points. So I moved some control points here, not sure which one. Let's try it again. I changed the direction. Now I removed these. That worked really good. And now I try the same here. That also worked quite nicely. So what if we add, what if we insert knots? It's kind of the same thing, really. It's not as strict, though. You can see that it's... but I want to show you something else, something also very interesting. And again, if I do this, toggle. But if, what if I insert a kink? Let's see. That makes a difference. Now we are actually on the surface. So the kink actually works the same way as the interpolated curve, interpolated points on a curve. Just that it's on the surface. And if I touch that, let's open it here again. So I created this kink here. That also is really a kink. It's, you only get this, you only really start to know these things if you play around with Rhino. That's also interesting. You can play with the whole surface and change from center out, but then it turns into a poly surface. If I now press enter, it changed from a surface into poly surface. You can see that here it says poly surface. So you can do quite some interesting stuff with these edit points. So they're not to underestimate, really. Now this tool here, the next one, and this I'm not sure what it is. Select curve of or surface edge to adjust. Let's see. There's a problem. I'm not sure about this. Why it happens like this? But yeah, you can adjust these isocurves. I'm not 100% clear about what it does, but if somebody knows, please tell me. It's a bit hard to grasp, I would say. You see, you can kind of, if somebody knows this, what is it for? Yeah, tell us. This one is more straightforward. This actually helps to control the weight of a point. So for example, here it might not be that visible if I add more divisions here. It's getting a bit out of control, I would say. Let's push this back here. Now, if I use this command, let's see, edit control point weight, then I can change here the weight of that control point. It basically kind of pinches the other points towards it. That's pretty cool. The drag mode, we did that also. there's another subset here. We looked into that with the curves. It's tricky. Yeah, just realized that my camera was finished. Drag modes. So how can I explain this drag modes? The drag modes, they basically define on how the points move when I move them. It's not a good explanation, but if I click here on this, you can actually see. I will select some of them to get a better understanding, get a better idea what they do. So seaplane, let's just go through and try it. But basically, it's a bit like the world coordinates, objects coordinates, and so on. So currently it's set to seaplane. Set drag mode, it's basically, you can choose between these, which are the same as this. So seaplane, now if I move these, they just move along the direction I'm moving the arrows of that gumball. Now let's drag this. What's the difference now? If I use the gumball, I can move this like this. If I change the world, it's similar. If I set the drag mode to U, V, and N, then it does something completely different. I think it's harder to explain than to actually try it. It actually gives you the small symbol, or the small text on what you're changing at the moment. This is drag mode to control points. They kind of move in relation to each other. The best way is really to just try it out. So this is something you really need to try for yourself and see what comes out. There's also always the help file. Never forget this here, the help file. So normally if you touch this, you should get like an automatic help, but not always the case. So here, yes, in edit mode for the points, we get immediately something, but not for this. So I could put drag modes and our gets hopefully something. Yes. And then you can go for these point for these stuff. See, it also has something to do with the drag strength and like the relation between the objects you move around. Anyway, that's this, and then move UVN. Let's see how that works. I think I need to select something in order to make this work. Yeah, and here's a bit hard because I have the weight on that point is so hard, is so strong. Let's see if I can make this reduce that again. I actually can. That's quite cool. So you can actually go back in time and remove the weight of that point. Basically, it's an additional kind of feature of that point, of that specific point. Now let's try this again. You can adjust things very, with the scale you can change the influence it has. That's good. Otherwise it's a bit hard to control. And then again, you have some options here. This, you can see it here. It's basically turns off the control points in the back. We will for sure get to that at some point when we go through more specific objects or projects. I mean, that's the idea, to give you very, very a deep dive into what can you do with the software, and then go and then try to have, and then create some, go through some practical projects. Yeah, control points. By the way, if I explode this and then put it together, then it's a closed object, but it's a different one than before. It's now it's not a poly surface. Now, if I actually use this, if I use now these objects here, So there's also a difference between these objects and polysurfaces. Although they are also polysurfaces, they are slightly different. Here I can actually also turn on control points. It only shows me three control points. One is this, and it does a weird thing. It actually, I would have thought it will move in a different way, but it does not, because it's actually defines the angle, or let's say the relationship between this point and this point, but it still stays a box. Now, if I choose this one, I can rotate that. That doesn't matter much. But I can also change the position of that point, which then is in relation to the other three points. It's quite interesting as well. So let's try the others. What would this be? There is this one. Again, it has three, and it does the same thing. Right. So this just rotates. If I move this one, then the other two points stay at the position where they are. I guess this doesn't make too much difference, but yeah. Let's see. Oh yeah, okay, here's a bit different. So solids have their own kind of interesting way of dealing with their control points. It's also interesting that these are basically kinks. That's it for today. Yeah, powerful control points. Control points are very powerful. Agree? Don't agree? Somehow also my t-shirt matches the color here. Should I make my background also blue? Mm-hmm. Okay, I think it's enough for today. It's control points are powerful. Remember that control points are powerful. Control points are powerful stuff. Remember.